Hello and welcome to another All About Apps edition from the Cleveroad studio. Our topic today concerns mobile app design. I'm going to give you some guidance based on best practice and our own experience. We will also consider how to be creative when following interface guidelines. Let's start with the last point and clear up what designer guidelines stand for. Remember that considering them as rules that cannot be broken is a big mistake. They are only recommendations, and it's up to you to follow them as you feel fit. Having said that, taking the guidelines into account does give you some obvious benefits. Namely, there is no need to think over many aspects that have already been developed and supplied for you. The app will look more natural for the operating system you're designing for. You have the ability to use your imagination, as the guidelines do not require you to follow them blindly. The most important thing about the interface guidelines is that they seek to achieve an effective user interface. Let's consider an example. Take a look at your phone. If you use an iPhone, you'll see a single button at the bottom panel. If you own an Android device, you'll notice three buttons in the same place. Obviously, the back button should be included into an iOS app, but it's not necessary for an Android application, since Android devices have a physical button. This is what UX stands for. Not only should the user be pleasantly surprised with the nice look, but also with the familiar feel when using your product. The correct placement of buttons, the sequence of pop-ups, the ability to easily interact with an app are the keys to its success. For this reason, the peculiarities of a mobile platform should be taken into account, and this is where the guidelines become of great importance. Nevertheless, your imagination is still in charge of creating an app which is going to stand out from the crowd. Not only can you design your own elements, but mix the existing ones provided by Apple and Google. Be careful not to cross the line though. It is unacceptable to copy the Android look into an iOS app or vice versa. However, you can consider adding some elements of the material design into an application which is going to run on an iPhone. A good illustration of this is a Facebook app for iOS. In particular, the floating button element, which is called out in the Android style guidelines. As you may have noticed, neither Apple or Google are going to limit your creativity. Still, you should not forget that adhering to the basic standards is essential if you don't want your application to look ridiculous for users accustomed to a particular operating system. Here are some key points to pay attention to. The search option on iOS is usually implemented as a separate field, whereas Android apps, there is a magnifier sign. The tabs in iOS applications are located at the bottom of the screen. Android applications tend to locate them at the top, next to the action bar. iOS switches are wider, with a characteristic light green color. Android ones are narrower, using a separate color palette. There are right arrows shown in iOS lists. Android does not employ them as a rule. The latest iOS version has opted for the San Francisco font. Android applications usually use Roboto. Both iOS and Android operating systems have specific icons. Using non-related icons may make the look unfamiliar and confusing for users. There are numerous iOS and Android devices. Make sure your app looks good on all of them. In conclusion, I would like to point out a couple of things for creating a high-quality design. Don't use more than three primary and three secondary colors in your app. Apply a limited number of fonts. Do not confuse asymmetry with imbalance. Leave a reasonable area of blank space. Arrange pictures using a grid pattern. Do not blindly imitate typical iOS or Android styles. Design separately for each platform. And last but not least, keep it simple. We hope our recommendations will serve you well. To read the full article about successful design, follow the link below. See you next time for another exciting story from the world of mobile applications. Have a great day and don't forget to subscribe.